popular children's movie is concealing a dark history that people didn't suspect. In 1995, Steven Spielberg brought us Balto, the tale of a brave sled dog and his perilous journey through the unforgiving Alaskan wilderness. This, however, was no mere work of fiction. Balto was real, and his heroism made him a legend. Yet while people were quick to celebrate the dog as a hero, he may not have been so deserving of the title. There's no denying Balto's role in preventing one of the greatest crises in Alaskan history. Though, there was another dog present during it all that truly deserves the most credit. History and Hollywood may have forgotten him, though from here on out, you'll never forget the name of the courageous canine that saved thousands from a terrible fate. It all began in Nome, a small city on Alaska's western coast. Today, the population sits at just under 4,000 people. In 1925, however, it was the most populous city in the entire state. Despite this fact, Nome was also one of the most difficult cities to reach, especially during the winter. The port that serviced steamship travel to Nome froze November to July, leaving the Iditarod Trail as the only link to the outside world. Sled dogs served as the primary means of transport along the Iditarod, delivering mail and other supplies to the people of Nome. But during the winter of 1925, these dogs were asked to carry something far more valuable. The call was put in by Dr. Curtis Welch, Nome's sole physician, after an increasing number of children were brought to him for treatment. Initially, he diagnosed them with sore throats and tonsillitis, until they started dying. Welch soon discovered that diphtheria was running rampant through Nome, and to make matters worse, his clinic's supply of antitoxin had expired. If he didn't get a new batch fast, the people of Nome and the surrounding regions, some 10,000 residents, didn't stand a chance. With the Iditarod only somewhat navigable, Superintendent Mark Summers of the Hammond Consolidated Goldfields proposed a dog sled relay to deliver viable antitoxin. From the central Alaskan city of Nenana to Nome, the journey would cover 674 miles of Arctic wilderness. Two teams were recruited for the trip, each starting at opposite ends and meeting at the small village of Nulato. A normal journey from Nenana to Nome typically took over a month to complete. They planned to do it in just 6 days. Beginning on January 27th, musher Wild Bill Shannon departed Nenana in negative 50 degree temperatures. By the time he met the next musher on his route, parts of his face had turned black from frostbite. From there, the antitoxin supply continued to change hands as each musher traversed the unforgiving Alaskan terrain. All the while, the death count was rising in Nome, and more cases of diphtheria were popping up each day. When the last member of the first team arrived at the town of Shaktulik, he was met ahead of schedule by Norwegian musher Leonard Sepala. A record holder and legend among the sledding community, Sepala was tasked with making the grueling trip back to Nome on his own. At this point, however, the number of diphtheria cases in Nome had epidemic proportions. In response, Governor Scott Bone ordered additional mushers to meet Sepala on the trail. Though in such harsh conditions, a rendezvous was no sure thing. Fortunately, Sepala was able to hand off the antitoxin to Charlie Olson at Golovin, who then delivered it to Gunnar Kassen at Bluff for the final leg of the journey. Fortunately, Kassen had a certain beloved husky at the front of his pack. Balto led Kassen through negative 70 degree temperatures and blinding blizzard winds, plunging confidently ahead through the pitch black darkness. Even after a large gust flipped Kassen's sled, Balto was able to rally the pack and continue onward to the next checkpoint. When the team arrived at Point Safety to make the last handoff, they found musher Ed Roan asleep, as he'd believed Kassen had gotten held up. With little time to spare, Kassen decided to sled the last 25 miles himself and arrived in Nome on February 2nd. With a fresh supply of antitoxin, Welch was able to cure all of his diphtheria sufferers, thereby preventing what threatened to be the worst epidemic in Alaskan history. In total, only 7 people perished, though more are believed to have died in the surrounding Eskimo camps. As for Kassen and Balto, both were celebrated as the heroes of the Great Race of Mercy. They received numerous awards and accolades for their role in the run, and the statue of Balto still sits in New York City's Central Park to this day. Yet not everyone held Kassen and his dogs in such high regard. Upon his return to Alaska, fellow mushers deemed Kassen a glory hog. And today, many believe that Sapala and his lead dog Togo were the true heroes of the relay. This fact is hard to deny, as Sapala's team covered 261 miles of their leg of the trip, more than double that of any other musher. Many also believed Ed Roan hadn't been asleep at Point Safety and that Kassen sledded to Nome just for the praise. Fortunately, Sapala and Togo did get their recognition in the end. Togo was awarded a gold medal from Antarctic explorer Roald Amundsen, and the team toured the country extensively before Sapala sold them to a kennel in Poland Spring, Maine. Believe it or not, most Huskies in the US today are actually descendants of Sapala's legendary team.